हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम फ्रॉम सीएससी डिपार्टमेंट, लालपुर खालसा कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, प्रेजेंटिंग दिस वीडियो फॉर सिमुलेशन एंड मॉडलिंग BTCS 601. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट नेटवर्क सिमुलेशन टूल्स. सो प्रायर मूविंग टू द सिमुलेशन टूल्स डिटेल्स, लेट्स फर्स्ट डिस्कस अ लिटल अबाउट network simulation. So what is a network simulation first? So as we know, a network system is a set of computer elements such as routers, switches, links, users and applications working together to achieve some task. So the scope of a simulation study may only a system that is a part of another system, as in the case of subnetworks. So here, the simulation is one of the most widely used techniques in network design and management to predict the performance of a network system. So before the network is physically built or the application is rolled out, we'll first prefer to simulate all the components of the network system here. The state of a network system is the set of relevant variables and parameters that describe the system at a certain time that compares the scope of the study. So for instance, if we are interested in the utilization of a link, so we want to know only the number of bits transmitted by the link. So in a per unit time, we'll compute the transmission of bits. So the total capacity of the link is also our emphasized area. So rather than the amount of buffer available for the ports in the switches, so we'll be focusing on the capacity of the link as well as the transmission of bits over the link. So instead of building a physical model of a network, we'll build a mathematical model representing the behavior and the logical and quantitative relationship between the network elements. So by changing the relations between network elements, we can analyze the model without constructing the network physically. And here, assuming that the model behaves similarly to the real system, that is, it is a valid system that we are simulating. We are available with n number of network simulation tools in the market. So let's discuss few of them. So they all will help us to simulate the network model. They will provide us with inbuilt libraries, classes, or the driven functions which can directly be embedded and used while simulation. So here is the list of various network simulation tools that are available in the market. Firstly, we are having NS2 network simulator. This particular simulator is a freeware or open source discrete event network simulator. It was developed at UC Berkeley, and it is available over the main page of nsnam.isi.edu. So this is the link given over here. From here you can directly download the setup and install the software and start performing. So it is basically a discrete event simulator which is targeted at networking research. NS2 provides substantial support for simulations of TCP. You can add your own protocols, contribute to the code. So here for it can be used for troubleshoot some of the bugs of network simulation in a discrete event simulator, where the advance of time depends on the timing of event, which is maintained by a scheduler. So NS2 can work under Linux, Mac, Windows, any. and its successive versions were NS3, which is also available over the main page of nsnam.org. NS2 has a large and rich library of network and protocol objects. It covers large part of applications, that is web, FTP, CBR protocols, and it also supports transport and routing protocols. So network type here we can use wired or wireless, any. NS also allow us to add and test new protocols and applications, or we can modify the existing one with the help of NS2. So NS2 is based on the object oriented simulator written in C++. The next network simulation tool we are having is OMNET++, which is available over the link omnetpp.org. So you can download it. It is also a openware software. So it provides us with the components based simulation package, which is built on C++ foundations. And it offers C++ simulation class library also. Moreover, it also supports the graphical user interface for graphical network editing and animation. So here it provides us with the components where we can easily drag and drop simply, and the corresponding code will be dragged. So it is also very simpler version to simulate the networks and to analyze our networks. Furthermore, we are having a network simulation tool, that is SSFnet. So it is available over the link which is given over here at www.ssfnet.org. So the full form of SSF is Scalable Simulation Framework. It is a standard for discrete event simulation, which is based in over Java and C++. So here several SSF implementations and a large number of open source protocol model can be evaluated and simulated, and other components exist in this particular SSF. So it provides us with various building blocks, SSF. So we can make use of these building blocks to simulate our models. So here are pre-existing protocols or the smaller components of a particular bigger complex system are also available, which can be used again and again to simulate our model. Next we are having is Parsec. It is available over the link given over here, and it is C based simulation language for sequential and parallel execution of discrete event simulation models. Furthermore, we are available with Scalable Networks, that is QualNet, which is available over the link of scalablenetworks.com. So you can download the setup for the installations from here, and network simulator design from the outset for maximum speed and scalability with the real-time simulation as an achievable goal. So here the analysis parameter will be speed and its scalability. So by using a scalable networks, we can generate the random numbers or we can generate the output parameters for server utilizations or routing parameters, so they can be analyzed at a higher rate at a faster speed. So the next we are available with the OpNet modeler, which is available over www.opnet.com. OpNet modeler is a commercial tool for modeling and simulation of networks, devices and protocols. So its features are graphical editors and animation. So again, it will provide us with the graphical user interface, and it will provide us with the graphical modules which can be simply dragged, and the corresponding codes will be dragged along, and this way we can formulate our models to simulate. but it is not a freeware software, so it is a commercial software. You have to pay for the same, and it also not only works for the network simulation, but other devices or systems or a small component of system, you can also simulate all those. The next available network simulation tool we are having is GIS-WANS, so which is available over gist.ece.cornell.edu. This is the link from where you can get this particular setup. And GIST is a high performance discrete event simulation engine. So it is basically revolves around the discrete event simulations. So these engines runs over a standard Java virtual machines. It is a prototype of a new general purpose approach to building discrete event simulators, which are called virtual machine based simulation. So here the resulting simulation platform is surprisingly efficient. So its overall performance is really high as compared to the other simulators, other simulation tools we are having in the market. So here its throughput is really high as compared to the other systems, and it is based over Parsec engine, which is C based Parsec engine, and supports process oriented simulation using a fraction of our memory. And due to the complex nature of computer communication, network models tend to be complex as well. So the development of special computer programs of a certain simulation problem is a possibility by using the network simulation tool. But it may be very time consuming and inefficient. So now in a recent scenario, the application of simulation and modeling package has become more customary. So it saves the coding time, as it allows the modeler to concentrate on the modeling problem in hand instead of the programming detail. So we have seen there are various simulation tools that provide the graphical animations or GUI support, so by which we the analyst need not to focus over the coding part of the model. Rather than the analyst can focus over the other parameters, performance parameters of the model. As previously, we were using the network simulation and the modeling packages as COMNET and OPNET, etc. So it creates the risk that the modeler has to rely on modeling technique and hidden procedures that may be proprietary or may not be available to the public. So by using the current available simulation tools, we can overcome the fears or risks for validation procedures to make sure that the real system will perform the same way as it has been predicted by the simulation model. So here we are going to emphasize on NS2 first, but prior moving to the discussions with NS2 tool, so firstly it is important to understand the difference between simulation and emulation. So the purpose of emulation is to mimic the original network and reduce every event that happen in every network element and application, whereas in simulation the goal is to generate statistical results that represent the behavior of certain network elements and their functions. So in discrete event simulation, we want to observe events as they happen over the time and collect performance measures to draw conclusion and the performance of the network, such as link utilization, response time, routers usage, और बफर साइज एटसेट्रा दैट कैन बी अवर की एम्फसाइज एरियाज. सो एज वी नो सिमुलेशन ऑफ लार्ज नेटवर्क्स विद मैनी नेटवर्क एलिमेंट्स कैन रिजल्ट इन लार्ज मॉडल दैट इज डिफिकल्ट टू एनालाइज ड्यू टू लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिकल जनरेटेड ड्यूरिंग सिमुलेशन. Therefore, it is recommended to model only those parts of the network which are significant regarding to the statics we are going to obtain from the simulation. It is crucial to incorporate only those details that are significant for the objective of the simulation. The network designer typically set the various objectives such as performance modeling to obtain the statics of various performance parameters of links, routers, switches, buffer, response time, etc. Then we can focus over the objective failure analysis, that is to analyze the impact of network element failures. Then we may emphasize over the objective, that is network design. So we have to compare statics about alternative network designs to evaluate the requirements of alternative design proposals. And lastly, we can emphasize over the objective, that is network resource planning, means to measure the impact of changes on the network's performance, such as addition of new users, new application or new network elements. So they all can be our key focus areas. So in the upcoming lecture we'll be going to start up with NS2 in detail. This is all for today's lecture. Today we have introduced about various network simulation tools that are available over the net. And we have discussed few openware softwares as well as the commercial ones. So we'll be discussing the network simulator 2 in next lecture. Thanks for today. Thank you.